Facing F1 visa rejection, well, this is a story that you need to hear. Pratima overcame 4 visa rejections to finally get her visa approved. Keep on watching. Hi guys, my name is Shachi and I'm a travel and a visa coach. On this channel, you will find lots of useful videos on the F1 visa process. There is an entire playlist for this, so make sure to check it out. One of the questions that I get asked really frequently is, does previous F1 visa rejections impact my visa chances? And the answer is yes, it can, and also no, it cannot. So see, here's the thing. It all depends on how your profile has changed, what has improved since the last rejection. In fact, this is one of the questions which is also asked by visa officers. You know, you can be asked, what has changed in your profile since the last rejection? So what you really need to do is to identify the mistakes, the things which went wrong, correct it, and then move ahead confidently. And this is exactly what Pratima did. So even after facing rejection 4 times, right, she did not give up. She prepared well, she worked hard, and finally she has a visa and now she is flying to the US. Before we dive into Pratima's experience, here's a snapshot of her profile. Education, BE in ENC, that's Electronics and Communication, followed by an MBA in HR. Work experience, 3 years working in the HR department of a IT company. Admit, Nova Southeastern University for Masters in Computer Science, and funding through loan and family savings. So she gave her interview last week at the Delhi Embassy, and this is her experience.
Hi.
Hello.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I want to share the story, right, of yours, because it is so amazing.
I would love to share my experience with you. So I have completed my engineering. Engineering was in electronics and telecommunication.
Okay.
And MBA is in HR.
In HR. Then you worked for 3 years.
Yeah.
HR, but IT domain.
IT,
right?
Domain, yes.
Okay.
And HR, then IT, I wanted to pursue
my MS.
Okay. Yeah, so 3 different things, but I wanted to pursue that. And that was very much challenging for me. And then I got you.
Yeah.
I met you. And I don't know that what happened that day. I just saw your videos. And then I thought, I should take some consultation with you. When I'll discuss with you, you can let me know that what exactly the process I have to follow. And then I contacted you. And it was first meeting was completely, I don't know that what I was talking when I heard all recordings. I was irritating my voice. I was getting what I'm saying to her, it is completely out of track. And then second time when I took the consultation, that was on the track.
Yeah.
And third time it was you got happy. And I thought are you are happy, then my visa interview was also happy. So this was all about my journey that I...
Tell us about the reject part. How many times did you apply and how you didn't give up?
So I went for the first time. I don't know that what was the officer mood and all. He asked me 12 questions. This was on the 18th of February.
Okay,
yeah, 18th of February. Yeah, this year only. And it was 12 questions, and that was I was playing Kon Banega Crorepati, and asking, and I was just giving. And then she said you're rejected.
Okay.
Then I tried for second time. I said okay, I'll try for second time. Then I went again to the Mumbai consulate, and that was, I guess, a Nigerian lady. She just asked me about my DS-116. I was got completely blank. Mm-hmm. I don't know that what to say, what not to say. And then I just shut my mouth and I was just looking at her. And then after 5 minutes, she said no, you're rejected.
Okay.
And then third time, I was confident, but I was not on actual track. When I saw my fourth visa interview, I was really on a track. I know that what I wanted to pursue. But in third interview, I got a mistake. He asked me only 3 questions. That was about my annual income, which I have, but I couldn't express him.
Hmm.
And then he was asking me about the difference between the computer science and IT, which I explained, but he was not getting what I mean to say, because I was technically explaining everything. He just saw me and I was completely blank, and then said okay, go. You're rejected. And only 3 questions. So 12, then 8, and then 3. And yesterday, only 4 questions. And
okay.
She said so it was in a Delhi.
Okay.
So right. Early morning, 8:30 was my appointment. With me, there was 150 people.
Okay.
And my counter number was 19. I was literally waiting for half an hour with a different counter, and actually the visa officer was taking the interview, and I was completely taking my breath in and out, in and out, and then I was doing a meditation there. I don't know why. I was like feeling very much nervous, and then she, like, lady said, like, you have to go to the counter number 19. I went there. There was two people in front of me, and they were like a junior than me, I guess. So they got selected. Then I was thinking, yeah, this is my turn. I don't know that what is going to happen. And I had a history of 3 back-to-back rejection. And then, like, I thought I am also going to reject. But then she asked me a first question that, I don't know, I have not heard about this university. It was a Nova Southeastern University. Yeah. It was in Florida. So she said, like, I have not heard about this university. So can you just explain how you have searched? So I explained her very properly that I have online research. My area of interest was this one. So I wanted to go for this college. This college is offering me this kind of subjects. So then when I told her a subject, then she said, can you just tell me the 2 subjects? I told her 8 subjects. Okay. Then she got impressed. So before I have contacted you, I have did some little bit research. That was, I guess, 5%. But when I met you and when you just explained me everything, then I have thoroughly go to the university profile and the courses and the electives. I have studied about the little bit about the each electives. And then I have explained her everything. As you have completing, like you have told me, like sweet and short should be there.
Okay, great. Because interviews are becoming so short, right? So
yes,
constantly people keep asking me that, you know, what should I do? So the point is, it's you have to give the right information, but yes, you know, in that really concise structure. So
then she asked me that, like, who is going to sponsor you? I explained her about my father's profession. And then she asked me, like, what is your funding? She was actually looking for the the funding, or like what is the bank balance I have. She was actually looking. She was not looking for the fixed asset, but I have properly explained the way we have.
So you first mentioned the loan,
then saving, and then my parents' annual income. Then she got impressed for that. Like, and then she said, like she threw my password other side, and I was like, what she's doing? Okay. And I thought like she's going to give me the tour for me, and then she said, like, take your service payment, I-20, go enjoy your study. And I was like completely blankly looking to her. She said, go run, enjoy your studies. And then I was literally crying. And I said, like, thank you so much. And from that moment I ran, and then till the hostel, like till my hotel, I was running. And I have informed my father, and he was like in a standing position when I call video call him, and he was completely sat down, and he said, like, oh, you got it.
Amazing. So that was, and this is a story which is like so heartwarming. Like, I can't express, like, you know, but, like, how nice it feels to hear your story.
But whatever it is, anything it is, only and only because of you. You have made me very much confident. I was too much nervous. I was out of my track. I was not clear about my answers. I have no formatting. I got when I have successful about my 4th visa interview. It got success. Then I thought, like, yes, I was on a track. I know everything, what I wanted to do, what was my aim, everything. But that all of because of you. All credit goes to you only.
No, I think it's definitely the direction helps, but end of the day, it's your effort, right? Because if you don't use the inputs, then, you know, it's not going to lead to any result. Because we work through multiple sessions, right? So I have seen session by session how,
yes, you know,
that progress was happening, that thinking was getting
streamlined. I think, like, taking a multiple sessions with you, that helped me a lot. Maybe I would take a 1 session or 2 session, that would not help me, because practice is more important. Even if you are working, then practice is more.
I think
you're
referring to the mock, right? We did like 2 or 3 mocks together.
Yes.
Yeah.
So that was too much helpful. And I was just remembering your last word, Pratima, please come. Please come. Don't be nervous. Then I was like sitting in front of the officer. I was just like, listen, your word only. Pratima, please come. Don't be nervous. And that made me a confident.
Amazing.
And like, I got my visa.
Amazing. So I am so happy that we met, right? That I could be part of your journey. All the best to you. You are an amazing person. I'm sure you'll do really well. Keep working hard. And one thing which I've noticed about you is through all the sessions, you always had that smile, right? Even though you were nervous, you had the smile. Even if you were crying, you had the smile. So, maintain that. That's amazing about you.
Your explanation, your understanding, and the way you're counseling to the people, that is so much helpful. Too much. Like, I love that we have this much a graph, but you're explaining in a short and sweet manner. I love the way that you're explaining every time. Thank you so much for this visa. And it's yours. It's not mine. It's yours. And all the best for your journey as well.
Bye-bye. Take care.
Bye.
So I hope Pratima's story has given you all the motivation and inspiration that you need. So if your visa also has been rejected this season, then do not give up. There is still hope. Work hard, prepare well, book your next slot and move ahead. If you have more questions for Pratima, you can reach out to her. Her LinkedIn profile is in the description box below. And if you need my help in your journey, I'm here for you as well. So you can either take a one-to-one consultation session with me. Here, we will figure out what are the things that went wrong during your last visa interview, which led to the rejection, and work on your answer structuring and proof-checking your funding plan and everything else. If you feel that you have prepared your answers and you just need practice, then a mock interview session is for you. So we will do a practice interview, right? We'll do repeated rounds of practice interview, and that will be followed by detailed analysis and answer structuring session. So the link for all of these things is in the description box below. Make sure to check it out. Also, I'm going to be making another detailed video on all the possible reasons why visas are getting rejected this year. I know that the visa interviews have gotten easier, but we are still seeing a fair number of rejections happen. So this video will cover all the reasons why visas are getting rejected so that you can prepare for these reasons and avoid them. So stay tuned for that video. Make sure that you subscribe and hit the bell icon. And before I end this video, I also want to tell you that the next F1 workshop is scheduled for 24th of July. That's Saturday, 24th July. So if you want to register for this workshop, the link for registering is in the description box. This is a great place to start your visa preparation journey. It's a 90-minute intense workshop, and we cover all aspects of interview preparation. Even if you're preparing for the next year, that is spring 2022, this workshop will be useful for you as well. So do join in. And yes, that's it for this video. Signing off for now. Lot more useful content coming your way. So stay tuned. Take care, and I'll see you again. Bye-bye.